Hi guys, there were two things that are immediate red flags for me over the years when it came to George Galloway. But first, let me explain where I agreed with him. Now, he was kicked out of the Labour Party for not going along with Tony Blair on the Iraq War in 2003. Now, some would say it was other stuff, but his stance was correct and history has proven that. However, where I'm concerned was where he railed against Scottish independence and cheered on Nigel Farage and Brexit. But the clip that got him in hot water is comments he made about gay people, suggesting that they aren't normal and that he didn't want something like that taught to his children. I'm not sure how normal it is to have one family in Scotland and another in England, but first let's hear his comments when he was interviewed by Navarra Media and then his meltdown on LBC, where he hung up after the slightest of pushbacks.
But there's two paragraphs here. One of them is in relation to what you just said about children and what they're taught. I believe in family. I'm a father of six children, five of them still at school, and I don't like some of the things they are teaching our children. So what specifically do you not like that's taught to children in schools?
Well, I don't want my children prematurely sexualized at all. I don't want them taught that some things are normal when their parents don't believe that they're normal. Now, there's lots of things not normal. Doesn't mean you have to hate something that isn't normal. But if my children are taught that there's whatever the current vogue number is, 76 or 97 or whatever the number of purported genders that exist, I don't want my children taught that.
But are they taught that?
Some of them are, yeah.
That's a lie. Who's teaching children that there are 97 genders? Do you have evidence to back up this claim? No, he doesn't. He's talking out of his hat. Is it normal, actually, for people to wear a hat inside? Anyway, he's lying here. There is no evidence to back up his claim. He could easily have said, look, this is the school that's teaching children that there are 97 genders. Now, what he's trying to suggest, I believe, is that children are being taught something when in reality children are being told it's normal to have certain feelings. It's normal to be a certain way. That's normal. For George Galloway, that's not normal. He doesn't explain what normal is, but let's continue.
There's a huge gap here between saying I think kids should be going to school and taught that, you know, not all relationships look like a heteronormative couple, male, female. There's a huge gap between saying they should know that there's lots of LGBT people in the world is very diverse, that's what it looks like, and you're saying 96 genders. There's a big gap in between, isn't there?
Well, no, three of my children go to school, a Catholic school in Scotland, so they have some protections for the moment, although the SNP government's threatening to remove some of those protections.
Protections. What does he mean by protections?
My other two school children are taught in England things that I don't want them to be taught. And at an age I don't want to be taught. That relations, that gay relationships are exactly the same and as normal as a mum, a dad, and kids.
Once again, what does he mean by normal? He doesn't explain what he means by normal.
I want my children to be taught that the normal thing in Britain, in society across the world, is a mother, a father, and a family.
When you define this as normal, you define everything outside that as abnormal. There's normal and there's abnormal. Now, you are defining people maybe in a situation by choice or in a situation not by choice as abnormal. How would you feel if the situation changed tomorrow and your situation was described as abnormal? Would you be happy with that? Would you be content with that? Would you say, well, look, this is the new reality? Or would you fight against it? And would you say, no, how dare you say my situation is abnormal? Because when you start to define things as abnormal, then you're automatically giving them a different situation. If they're in a different situation, then you're going to, of course, deny them certain rights. Now, he will say he's all for equality. But if you're defining a group of people as abnormal or their situation as abnormal, then of course they can't have the same rights as normal people. Now, you would probably say you don't agree with that. But by defining a group of people as abnormal or their situation as abnormal, then it will lead to that eventually.
I want them to be taught that there are gay people in the world and that they must be treated with respect and affection as I treat my own gay friends and colleagues.
But not equality. They shouldn't be the same as us. That's what he's trying. These people should not be beaten. They should not be tortured. They should not be persecuted. But they're not the same as us.
Respect and affection. But I don't want my children to be taught that these things are equal, because I don't believe them to be equal. Apart from anything else, the human race would no longer exist. If it was normal, then it would be the end of humanity over a couple of generations.
Okay.
So I don't believe that it's normal. Normal is a man, a woman, and children.
Now, once again, I come back to this point. What if people can't have children, either for biological reasons or economic reasons? Is that normal in your mind? Obviously, it's not. And if you define it as abnormal, then of course you're going to eventually decide, well, these people need to be in a different category. They're abnormal. They shouldn't have the same rights as normal people. Now, George, of course, spoke to LBC. He was challenged on some of the points he made here. And, well, it didn't go down very well.
So, Mr. Galloway, just to recap what you said there, I don't want my children to be taught that these things, i.e. gay relationships and heterosexual relationships, are equal because I don't believe them to be equal. We'll come back to the question of the other word you use, which is normality.
Well, we won't,
but specifically equal, why aren't they equal?
Lewis, we won't actually come back to it because, first of all, that's not what this interview is about. You got this interview to talk about the election. Secondly,
you don't think that these are important remarks?
Lewis,
you're a leader of a party.
Lewis, this is a clip of a clip. It's an edited clip.
No, it's not. No, it's not an edited clip.
Yes,
no, it's not.
It is a.
It is a full.
He's running away. Now, I will leave the full interview in the description of this video, and I do recommend checking it out. It's very interesting. He says some very interesting things, apart from describing some people as abnormal or suggesting that they're not normal. But he's running away from it. He's trying to suggest this is a hatchet job. This is a smear campaign. Repeating his own words back to him is a smear campaign.
90 seconds of what you said.
No, it isn't. You clipped out the point about the 97 genders.
No. That's a separate question. You chose
agenda. You clipped it out.
Gender what?
Don't think I don't know what I said.
He's a gender agenda. We can add an extra one to the list. How many Venn diagrams does George Galloway fit into? Should we ask him about climate change?
We just played what you said, Mr. Galloway. We want to know.
You clipped it out. Look, I'm not going to have a Barney with you because
I don't want a Barney. I'm just trying to understand what you said.
I came on here to speak about the elections.
Of course.
Now you're ambushing me.
It's not an ambush, Mr. Galloway.
It's not an edited clip.
So I've got unedited clip.
I've got a simple answer. Listen,
why aren't gay relationships equal to heterosexual relationships, Mr. Galloway?
Listen to the whole thing tonight.
I've listened to the whole thing.
You haven't given your listeners
Mr. Galloway, you're
the
not.
Whole thing.
No, you're misleading That's, my listeners in saying
listen,
that. You're misleading my listeners.
I'm sorry?
You're misleading my listeners in saying that because we have not edited the clip. That is a full 90-second exchange.
You did edit the clip.
No.
We did the transgender bit.
The transgender bit is separate. Yes, it is part of the longer minutes.
I'm going to hang up now because
you don't want to explain yourself.
Thinking.
It's not a fool. You're
more
a politician. Grow up, Mr. Galloway.
Or fool me thinking that your request that I come on and talk about the elections was genuine.
Of course it was genuine. Well, there you go.
There you go. You know, I was wrong to compare George Galloway to Nigel Farage. We should compare him to Donald Trump. He's as thin-skinned as Donald Trump. running away from an interview, running away from his own words. He could have easily had come out and said, look, this is what I meant when I said this, and cleared it all up. But he ran away. What a coward. Like Boris Johnson, like Donald Trump, running away from your own words. It's not even running away from a difficult situation. You created this problem yourself. Nobody forced you to do these interviews. Nobody forced you to say that there is a normal type of relationship and there is an abnormal type of relationship. Look, I've said before, this guy is a charlatan. He's very much like Nigel Farage, an attention seeker. When it comes to elections, he's a carpetbagger. He'll just go wherever he thinks he can win a seat, and he did that in Rochdale. He manipulated the public by sending out two types of leaflets, one for the working class white people and another for the Muslim community. One saying, I'm going to focus on Rochdale, on the problems facing Rochdale, and the other was about Gaza. He's a charlatan, and unfortunately, people are buying into it. Now, when I said at the beginning about the Iraq war, he was right, and I commended him for that. But everything else, Brexit, him saying that he supported Nigel Farage because, you know, the European Union is an absolute disaster that the UK needs to leave. When it came to Scottish independence, basically calling people who support independence as traitors. You know, he's a horrible individual, but as a politician, he's pretty pathetic. Let me know in the comment section, guys, what you think. As always, your comments are greatly appreciated. Thanks a lot.